Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss a problem that is based on Elingham diagram. Let's see the question. The correct statement regarding the given Elingham diagram is. So this is the Elingham diagram that is given, which is basically delta G naught versus temperature. And these are the four options we have to select. Okay. Now the first one is, at 800 degrees centigrade, copper can be used for the extraction of zinc from geranium. At 800 degrees centigrade, at this temperature, you can say we will see this vertical line. Okay, it is saying that copper is used for the extraction of zinc from geranium. It means it is saying that this reaction will be feasible. This reaction will be feasible at 800 degrees centigrade. Okay, let's check. If you see, this is the point on the curve, aluminium plus oxygen forming L2O3. Okay, this is the point on the curve of Cu. This is on ZnO and this is on Cu2O. We know that lower the delta G naught value, more is the stability of oxide. Okay, so if we see at 800 degrees centigrade, delta G naught value is lowest for alumina, L2O3. So if you talk about the stability, L2O3 will be most stable, followed by carbon monoxide, then ZnO, and then Cu2O. So we can say that ZnO is more stable than cuprous oxide or copper 1 oxide. So this reaction will not be feasible. Since at 800 degrees centigrade, ZnO is more stable than copper 1 oxide, so copper will not be able to reduce ZnO, because ZnO is more stable and this is less stable. So reaction will not, you know, give you less stable product, okay, if it is feasible. So first one is not feasible. Okay, now let's see the next one. At 1400 degrees centigrade, aluminium can be used for the extraction of zinc from ZnO. So now we'll see at 1400 degrees centigrade, what is the stability order? Okay. If I say at 1400 degrees centigrade, suppose the temperature will be somehow here. Let's say this is 1400 degrees centigrade. So let me draw a vertical line here. It will be like that. This is the point on, you know, curve L2O3. This is the point on curve Co. This is Cu2O. Okay. And then if you extend it, suppose if you want to extend it, yeah, this will be the point on, you know, ZnO. Okay, so approximate stability will be like that. Let me write it. L2O3 again is most stable. Okay, followed by this one, that is Co. Then it will be Cu2O followed by ZnO. Okay. Now in this case, it is asking about this reaction, aluminium reacting with ZnO forming L2O3 and zinc. Okay. Yeah, aluminium can be used to reduce ZnO. Okay. Is it feasible? So if I say yes, why? Because alumina, L2O3, is more stable than ZnO. This is more stable and this is less stable. So this is more stable oxide, alumina. So aluminium to alumina formation tendency is more as compared to zinc to ZnO. So this reaction will be feasible. Okay. So we know that a more stable oxide has more tendency to form, and that's why it will form easily. But in the first case, it was just opposite. You know, this was more stable and this was less stable. So that reaction was not feasible. Delta G naught for that reaction will be positive, not feasible. But here it will be negative. It will be feasible reaction. So second option will be the correct one. Let's see the next one. At 500 degrees centigrade, coke can be used for the extraction of zinc from ZnO at 500 degrees centigrade. Okay, so let's see, this is 500 degrees centigrade, and if you see here, this is the first point, this is the second point at 500, this is the third point, this is the fourth point. And at 500 degrees centigrade, if I just write the stability order of the oxide, I will say alumina is lying below having the maximum value of negative delta G naught, so it will be most stable. So Al2O3 is most stable, followed by ZnO, followed by CO, and then followed by CO2O. Okay, so again, it is asking about the reduction of ZnO by the coke. So reaction will be ZnO plus coke giving zinc plus CO. And again, I can say this is not feasible. Why? Because this is less stable and ZnO is more stable. So ZnO is more stable oxide than carbon monoxide. So carbon will not be able to reduce it. Okay. So reaction will be feasible if we are going from less stable to more stable. Here it is more stable and it is less stable. So that is again not feasible. Delta G naught for this will be greater than zero. Okay. So to reduce ZnO, this carbon to CO curve should be lying below this curve. Then only it will reduce. Okay. Let's see the next one. Coke cannot be used for the extraction of copper from CO2O. Okay. So let me write the reaction. CO2O plus coke giving copper plus CO. Okay. If we see this reaction, CO2O plus carbon giving copper plus CO, is it feasible or not? So I can say it is feasible at all the temperature, we can say except this lower range. Here it is feasible at 500 degrees centigrade. It is feasible because at 500 degrees centigrade, which is more stable? CO is more stable and CO2O is less stable. So this curve, talking about this curve for the carbon monoxide, this curve is lying below than CO2 curve for a long range of temperature. So this is possible, but it is saying that coke can't be used. That is a wrong statement. Coke can be used for the reduction of CO2 to copper. So the correct answer should be the B. Thank you.